Hi, we're in Labart.
Thanks for having us.
Of course.
This is Rachel Jolson. She is the co-owner, right, with your brother Iskander of Labart.
There's other galleries that hold street art or street artists, but nobody as big as us, and it isn't really, nobody else is like really geared towards like up and coming street artists.
So what would you consider street art?
Well, street art is basically the different art that you would see literally out on the streets, whether it's like billboards that different artists have taken over, or electrical boxes, how there'll be wheat paste on there. It kind of ranges in different types of ways. So we showcase the fine art of street artists. So what you see in here might be very different from what you see in the street. So if you look at somebody like Desire Obtain Cherish, he takes over billboards. And that's mainly like what he does in his street art. And then his fine art, he does a lot of sculptures, or he does the lollipop that we walked past. So there's a huge difference between what you see out in the streets and what you see as their fine art.
Is street art vandalism? And how would you feel if a street artist would paint a wall in your house?
It depends what kind of art was painted on the wall of my house, but I would more likely than not like it, knowing myself, and appreciate it. But it is vandalism. It is what it is. Like, you can't call it anything else. But it's a beautiful way of vandalism. You know, there's a technique to it. You know, these are artists. It's not just, you know, scribble scrabble. So it definitely is, and it's not legal. But it's beautifying our city. That's how I see it.